What's up, guys? Welcome back to Life is Strange, episode 2, part 2. So we're gonna head downstairs now to have breakfast. We're gonna get dressed first here. Don't mind my frog boxers or underwear. It's just, you know.
All right.
Teenager shit.
I'm allowed to go out now.
All right. I'm allowed to go out now. Let's do this.
Sean, finally.
Sean, are you awake? Breakfast's almost done, so come down when you're ready, okay?
Okay.
Okay. All right, let's go have breakfast.
Choo-choo!
Yeah.
Oh, careful, Chief. They're going too fast.
We have to. We're late on schedule.
Yeah, but we're gonna scare the passengers away.
Ooh, a nice little fish tank. Those are always so relaxing.
Oh, my.
What up, Grandma?
Look who's awake. Good morning, sleepyhead.
It's that.
Oops, sorry.
Daniel, breakfast time. Your brother is ready.
Grandma, show me your pop star.
Steven, your grandson needs to eat now. You can show him the boxcar later. I love how they're getting along.
What's on the menu? Need help? Sure.
Do you need help or anything?
Oh, don't worry. I can do this in the dark. But thanks for the offer.
All right.
Are you boys done playing?
We had an express delivery with the passengers, but the engine broke down.
Yep, has to go straight to the workshop.
Good. No trains in the kitchen, remember?
Gotcha, Chief.
Choo-choo!
Ah, sugar. He can fix his trains, but not my kitchen. Did I make enough? Everything's okay?
It's great. As usual.
You're the best cook ever.
Looks like you're getting cozy with this new country life after all.
Yeah. It's nice to be far away from everything. Feels like we're the only ones out here.
Well, that's exactly why we love it. It feels safe, unlike the big city.
I get it.
I like it. It's cool here.
Well, bless your soul. You'd get along good with our neighbors. We try to lend a hand. Like to Charles next door. He lost his wife and...
Oh, Charles
things
is...
Things have been hard on him and his son.
That's the dad of
he
the...
He would just get lost in Seattle. But we're all taking care of him here.
It's Captain Spirit's dad.
How old is his son?
I think he's your age.
Ooh, cool.
He was eating a blank fork. Oh, God.
Stop it, you crazy?
Hey, what's going on back there?
Nothing.
I thought Steven was a fast eater.
Hey, Grandma, I wanted to ask you something about that locked room upstairs.
I told you there is nothing to see in it, Daniel.
Why were you in it this morning, then?
Because there's a lot of old junk in there. And besides, it's not safe for you to explore, okay?
But we'll be fine.
Why don't you go explore outside? You sure look like you're getting better.
It looks like you wasn't kicking ass.
I'll wait for Sean, and then we'll go. We won't be loud. Promise.
But be careful nobody sees you. Stay in the back, okay?
Maybe you should tell him that it was Karen's room.
It's just a room now, Sean. Nothing to see.
Why lock it then? It feels like you're hiding something.
There's no secret. We just want to move on with our lives, Sean. So nobody goes in the room, okay? I'm serious.
Did Mom ever contact you? She only talked to Dad a few times. Then she was gone.
Yes, she was. You know, Sean, I don't really want to talk about this anymore. It's over. Anyway, you have to respect my rules under my roof, okay?
Of course. Always.
I appreciate that, Sean. Now you better go find your brother. There's a shed with some old toys outside. I'll bet Stephen has the key.
Danny, old freak. Thank you.
I have a feeling that whatever's going on with their mother is not as bad as it seems. Like, maybe she's got special powers, too. That's where Daniel's originated from. I don't know. That's kind of like... It's kind of like the vibe I'm getting here. All right. Where is Steven? Yo, Steven! Where you at, homeboy?
I better catch up with Steven and get those keys. Daniel's going nuts in here.
5x4? 30?
Hello there, Steven.
Think I need a handy assistant. Can you hand me the glue? In
the cup.
Whoa! Careful. Sorry, I forgot. That thing isn't too stable. Let me just...
Okay. Sorry.
Wow.
My fault. Your grandmother keeps telling me, but I'm a lazy old man. Hey, can you close the door? I want to talk for a second.
Oh.
Why do I still hear the freaking faucet from the kitchen?
It's the power cable, of course. Yeah, it happens all the time. So, listen, I've noticed things.
Is that normal?
With Daniel. You know that what noise I'm is annoying. Talking about, don't you?
Nah.
Not really. What things?
Well, I'm not sure how to put it. Like, some kind of invisible force. The holy gift or something.
Yeah. Daniel likes to pretend he's got superpowers, but that's it.
That's it? Okay. But be careful, Sean. You know, he's still so young.
Sure.
And by the way, let's keep this between us. Claire has a lot of strong beliefs. She wouldn't understand. She adores Daniel. And just wants both of you to be safe and happy.
I mean, I should have probably been straight up with him.
What I'm trying to say is maybe you should stay here with us. I know you boys plan to run to Mexico, but...
This guy knows everything. Puerto Lobos. Why not?
Thanks. Maybe we could, but... Why not?
I know, being out here in the sticks with us old farts isn't exciting, but this is your home now.
It's cool. Kinda different, but... I just don't want you to get into trouble because of us.
It's dangerous to be on the road. Do you think your father would have wanted this for his kids?
Of course not. everything's different now.
I know. Well, just think about it. But don't torture yourself.
I will. Hey, Claire said you had the keys for the tool shed?
Oh, sure. Here. You guys enjoy the sun. And be careful with that shed. It's probably a mess inside.
Thanks.
All right.
It's good to see you in my lair. You know, you were afraid to come in here as a kid.
Really? In my lair.
Why?
No idea. But you're a big boy now. You can take a look around. I won't eat you.
Cool.
It's okay, man. All right. Let's get the story across.
Ah, here you are, Sean. Got the key? Hey, I have to go out and run some errands. Can you do me a big favor? Do you know how to work a washing machine?
Since I was about 8.
Of course. Can you throw in yours and your brother's clothes after the next load? They're in the bathroom basket.
Totally, yeah. No problem.
Thank you so much. Feel free to start tidying your stuff, too. It's good for the health to keep a house clean.
Definitely. Daniel can help.
Ah, and remember, for your own safety, no phone and no internet. I know, boring rules.
Don't worry, Claire. Hey, Daniel! There's work for you.
No, I'm busy.
Busy my ass. Come over here.
Just a little shit at. Willing to bet he's not down there. Why is this frickin'... See, I hear like a faucet or something. Like something's on the entire time. Could that be like the,
I get that he's sick of all this shit, but why are we playing this game?
Could that be like a glitch or what? Aw, this little shit opening doors with his force.
Oh.
What a little shit.
We spent the whole week locked up in that. Better not sneak in. They won't like it.
Okay.
It's been locked ever since we got here.
Alright, so that's Karen's room.
I kinda don't give a fuck.
Yo, he's gotta be in here.
I know you're in there.
Gotcha!
What the?
Behind you!
Yeah. Very funny. No more hiding. Seriously.
Okay. What do I have to do?
You tidy the mess in our room, and I take care of the laundry. Cool?
Yeah, sure. It's hot.
I know. Thanks.
Alright. Where is the laundry room? It's not upstairs.
Okay. Easy peasy.
What is this kid doing?
Dude, can't you do this with your own hands?
Yes, I can. But it's quicker this way.
You'll go all numb if you keep on doing this. You know?
Yes, I know. Smarty pants.
Alright. Laundry room. Where are you? It's gotta be here. All right. Note. What does the note say?
As always with Claire, I can't really tell if this is cute or bossy.
Dear husband, if you do laundry, please follow these simple rules. Do not mix whites and colors ever. Use 1 cup of detergent, red box for each load. If you wash my clothes, use the delicate cycle. so you don't ruin any of my clothes. Love, why? Damn. Just wash the clothes, I guess.
How many programs does this thing have? Okay. It will do.
Now what? Okay, can we go back to Daniel? See what he's up to? Alright, maybe still... Oh, he's right here. What up? What up, Daniel?
Whoa. Look at all these decorations.
That's so cool.
Alright. Let's get out there.
Daniel! You ready? We can go out now.
Yes! Wait for me!
He was just there. What? Is this when they're gonna meet Captain Spirit? Yo, what? What are you doing?
Shh.
What are you doing over there?
What did Claire say?
Oh my God. Wait, there's a glitch in this.
What did Claire say?
Oops. You're right. Sorry.
That's Captain Spirit's house over there, is it? Is it that one? I think it is. I don't know. There's whichever one. Oh, it's that one over there. Yeah, it's over
Morning
here.
Morning laundry. Done.
It's this one. Look at the treehouse.
Fresh air.
Yes, it's this one.
Whoa. Looks pretty awesome. Lucky kid,
man, you have no idea what that little boy's going through, man. All right, let's see what Daniel. Oh, we gotta go to the shed. Hold on a minute, man. Open the shed.
Get ready for storage wars.
Probably clean as hell.
What's wrong?
Frozen shut. Of course.
There it goes, there it goes.
Sean, look!
Oh, shit. He's probably like, oh my God, I got special powers.
See what? We just got here. Are you okay?
Yeah. I didn't see anything either.
Okay. I just fell down into the snow. Dad says I'm kind of clumsy.
That's an awesome costume. Who's your favorite superhero? I love Power Bear.
Oh, man! I have the Mega Power Bear. You should check it out.
Dude, that's so cool.
Chris, oh, God.
Oh, no.
I am so sorry. Are you okay?
Dad, I'm fine. I promise.
Are you sure? Listen, I shouldn't... Do you know them?
It's okay, Dad. They're cool. He loves superheroes, even Power Bear.
Ah, gotcha. Hey there. Are you staying with the Reynolds?
Our grandparents just passing by.
Yeah. But not for long. We're just passing by.
I see. Oh, geez, Chris. You don't have any damn shoes on. I'm sorry, buddy. Let's get you inside.
Yeah. Okay, Dad.
Thanks, guys. Oh, and, if Claire asks, tell her everything is fine.
Is it Really?
Never mind. See you around.
Sure.
Thanks, guys. See you later.
Yes, we will.
Daniel, did you forget everything about the rules already?
Sorry, Sean. Did you want me to let him fall? Really?
Remind the rules. Concede. We gotta reinforce the damn rules.
I know you only wanted to help, but it's too dangerous for both of us.
Whatever. Rules are boring.
Yeah, but it'll be worse than boring if we get busted out here. Come on, Daniel. Steven already saw you using your powers.
Fine. I'll be careful. I'll never help anybody again. Okay?
Daniel, remember that we're hiding out, so no training and no showing off your power. From now on, you stick with me all the time, okay?
All right. Sounds good. It's hard, man. It's hard to decide whether you want to tell him to use the powers or not. I mean, I want him to use the powers, but I'm trying to get a good ending here. I'm trying to get something positive. I don't want to screw everything up. That's why my decisions are kind of like, you know, it's hard. It definitely is. I mean, if I had special powers, I'd probably do the same. Or worse. I'd use them every single fucking minute that I possibly can. So be recruited. Oregon the next morning. Draw a line.
Oh, fuck.
I'm at the neighbors.
That kid never listens.
Oh, God. Oh, that's a handkerchief from Mushroom. Oh, so sad. All right, so the objective now is get dressed. Go get Daniel at the Erickson's. Okay, I need to get dressed. Let's get dressed. Alright. Let's do this.
Claire? Steven? Anybody home?
Hello? No? Oh, okay. No.
Well, I guess they won't be back for at least 2 hours.
Morning, sleepyheads. We'll let you sleep in today while we were at church. Back by noon for lunch. See you in a bit. Love Grandma and Grandpa. We just tied up everything. Tidied up everything, so no rough housing, please.
Maybe I could use Steven's laptop. It's been ages since I've had news from the real world.
Oh, shit. Here we go. Breaking the rules.
Jeez. These articles are almost a month old.
Oh, wow.
Maybe they stopped looking for us?
Seattle shooting. Blasting shooting. An unresolved mystery. Officer Tanska holds press conference on Seattle incident. SPD still considering every lead, including terror attack and gang fight. More questions than answers in Seattle. Incident as friends and neighbors mourn loss of local mechanic. Oh, man.
What the hell is this? Had no idea Steven could fall for this bullshit conspiracy theories.
All right, let's log in.
Holy shit. Who are these assholes? That's some fucked up hate speech.
Oh my god, we logged into his fucking Twitter, dude. Alexa Stone, cop killer. You can run, but you can't hide. Corey Alexander, this is what happens when you let cockroaches in the kitchen. Strong boy, I've got a .38 bullet with you and your brother's name on it. Sleep tight, kids. I just reported you for death threats. And go back to China, dog eater. Clementine Koshak. I'm Mr. Diaz, I'm a reporter, blah, wow. Blah, blah.
Lila seems to be having a hard time.
Lila, that's his friend.
Never seen her this salty.
What else? Okay.
I should really call Lila to check on her.
Dude, don't call her, man. Come on, don't be an idiot. All right, now what? Call Lila. Do we really want to call her? I don't think so. I don't think that's a good idea, man. Yeah, I don't want to read the entire thing. It's just way too much shit to read.
Okay. Let's get this brack back home now.
But it's pretty much a bunch of conspiracy theories, a bunch of, you know, the news outbreaks, and just everybody's still looking for us. So yeah, the case is still open.
Why does Daniel never listen? Maybe I'm too soft with him.
Let's knock on the door. Enter? Are we just gonna enter like that? What?
Daniel, what's going on here?
Sean, wait, don't freak out. I can't explain.
Let me tell him. Sean, I know it sounds crazy, but I have a superpower. You saw me yesterday. I know you did. I was flying. I can move things, objects, with my mind.
Oh, superpower. Really?
Yes.
Great. And you don't realize what that implies? Everyone can see you from the outside. You could get in real trouble. This is dangerous. Do you understand?
Yes. We hear you. We promise to be careful.
This is just our secret, okay? Nobody can find out I'm the real Captain Spirit.
And nobody will. Ever.
Now you're an official member of the Spirit Squad. If you betray us, I'll disintegrate you. Nah, just kidding.
Oh yeah, we need a team signal. Totally. I'm gonna be Super Wolf.
He's like, what?
What's your super name, Sean?
Don't need one. Silver Runner, El Diablo Loco. Yep.
I don't know. Something cool like El Diablo Loco.
Diablo Loco, okay.
Sounds like a supervillain's name, but okay.
Okay, guys, I think we're ready to roll. Excuse me. Who are you?
I'm Sean.
Oh, yeah. Sorry, man. You're here for Daniel. Hey, let's make it official. I'm Charles Erickson.
Nice to meet you.
Hope you know that Daniel and Chris are a dangerous team. We better watch out, or they're gonna take over the world.
Yeah, they share a lot of things, as thick as thieves.
Can we go get the Christmas tree now? We're both ready to fly.
Yes, yes, yes. The team has been waiting too long. Hey, you should come along too. There's nothing going on over here.
Yes, can't wait to see all the decorations. And Sean, we could buy Christmas presents for Grandma and Grandpa.
Dude, I know I'm picking like the bitchiest options here, but
well, they'll worry if we leave the house. And remember, you still have to get better, Daniel.
Sean, come on. You know I haven't done anything fun since I got sick. It's the first time I've been out for days.
We won't be gone for long. The market's only a few miles away. Anyway, they'll be at the service for at least another hour.
Yeah, Sean, I can show Daniel around. You can come with us. Please say yes.
Please, please, please.
Okay, you win. Not a fair fight. So let's go.
Yes! Yeah!
I guess we're going.
See? Dangerous. Okay, team, give me a time out to clean up the back seat. I'll honk when I'm done.
Ooh, can I use the bathroom?
Of course. Oh, you'll see my comic books. I'm glad you're coming too. Hey, you want to see my toys?
Oh, score! The new hot dog man?
Since you're a new member of the team, you have to know everybody. These are Captain Spirit's friends. And his enemies.
Dude, that's pretty cool.
Can you guess who are the good guys and the villains?
Let's see.
Alright. So, the good guys. So, warrior. That's probably...
Careful. It may be tricky.
Okay, these are villains.
Interesting.
Villains, heroes. Let's see here.
Look closely.
Villain. Pirate. This guy's probably a villain.
The bad guys, the good guys. Not that easy, right?
Hero and hero. And
look closely.
Okay. No. It's not a... Heroes, heroes. Heroes, villains. Also, this guy's...
You sure?
All right, man, that's it. What the hell? Confirm? No. Okay. Wait. This guy's a hero.
Careful.
This guy...
It may be tricky.
...is a hero. And confirm.
Okay. How did I do?
Not bad. You're almost right. It was a bit tricky. Okay. Let me introduce them to you. This is Team Spirit. The good guys. There's the Forest Warrior. Power Bear. Marty Rex and Sky Pirate.
So, who are the bad guys?
That's Noctarius and the Shark Stinger. There's also Snowmancer, but he's out in the garden. Captain Spirit kinda took care of him. He might need a little surgery now. But they're all working for Mantroid, who is the real supervillain. You should see his evil planet.
Why doesn't Captain Spirit stop him?
He tried. But failed. That's why he needs Super Wolf. You know, Daniel. To prevent Mantroid from hurting other people.
Yeah. Strength in numbers. Sounds like Mantroid is in trouble.
Just wait until he sees what Captain Spirit can do now.
Yeah. About that.
Your father knows. Not afraid.
Does your dad know about any of this? Did he see something yesterday?
No, he didn't see anything, and the power didn't work yesterday. After I fell. must have been too tired.
Okay, good. He could be pretty disturbed if he knew.
I'm definitely not telling Dad. I don't wanna... freak him out. He's worried about other stuff anyway.
What treehouse? All cool with him?
Chris? It's none of my business, but are you and your dad okay?
What do you mean?
I don't know. Claire seems to be worried about you guys.
Claire's always worried. We're cool. Totally. He has a hard time being on his own. That's all.
Chris. I know life can get pretty tough. Trust me. But you'll be okay. You're an awesome kid.
Thanks, Sean. But I don't feel scared anymore. I have the power, and I have Daniel.
There's the signal. Come on, Daniel.
Hey!
Now, I think when we go to...
Pro tip, don't go in there.
Yeah.
Okay, squad. Dump. Let's roll.
I think when we go now with these people, we're going to get in deep shit. I think that's what's going to make the episode turn.
You need my jacket? I don't want you catching another cold.
No, I'm good. Thanks.
And don't be putting your arms around when I'm driving, okay?
Yeah. Remember, Daniel, don't mess around.
All right. Jeez.
Thanks for clearing the snow from the porch.
You're awesome.
You're welcome, Dad.
Okay, buddy, you ready?
Yeah. Hey!
You guys go ahead and we'll come back to meet you, okay? Brothers meeting.
Sure,
but
don't get lost.
Dude, what the fuck are you doing? I can't believe it. How many times do we have to keep going over the rules?
Don't show the power. I know. But Tris thinks he can do all this cool stuff. I wish he could. He reminds me of Noah. I just miss having friends, Sean.
Stop lying to Chris.
Listen, I understand, but we have to be extra careful out here. You can't let people see you. You know the rules.
Yes, I know the rules. But I'm careful. I only do things when it's me and Chris. Nobody sees us.
Yeah, nobody but me. What if it was Chris's dad? Or grandma? Or a cop? Or...
Okay. I get it. But I'm careful.
That's not enough. You have to be extra, extra careful.
All right. I swear I will.
Deal. I'm counting on you, Anano.
Can I go see Chris now?
Yeah, let's go. But don't forget what I said.
Oh, Lord.
Wow. So many trees.
So, are you gonna look at trees or go look at Chris?
Giant cocoons. Creepy. You coming, Sean?
Don't worry. I'll be around.
Let's see, what's the objective? Find Daniel a Christmas present. Let's see here. Can we go this way? Donation box.
Okay. Better find a gift for Daniel quick.
Quiet money
while he's still
usual.
Busy with Chris.
Good. Tell me if you need anything, okay?
Sure. Yeah. I'm fine for now.
Gifts.
Got all the supplies in my truck, so don't worry.
We only sell handmade local products.
All right.
Come take a look.
$5. $7. Sorry, Daniel. I'm gonna have to pick a $5 one because your boy's broke. Okay. Yeah, let's pick this one. So, pay.
I'd like one of those snowman things.
Of course. They're handmade by local kids.
Cool.
Sure. Let's just pay.
Here you go.
Thanks. Anything else?
No. I'm good.
Have a nice day, then.
Yeah, you too. Thanks.
I would have at least worn a hat or something, man.
Cool. Mission accomplished. We better leave now, before Claire and Steven come back.
Found what you were looking for, City boy?
Yeah. Something for my little brother.
You bought your brother something out here. Damn. Poor kid. Sorry. I'm just a grumpy old gal. Me and my friends have been crashing here for the week. Nobody gives a shit about us. Yeah, I can tell you're not from around here.
No. No way. Just here for the holidays.
Ah. You got family.
My grandparents.
Gotta love the grandparents.
What about you and your friends? Road trip?
Not really. We kinda hop from place to place, hunting for little jobs.
Must be a long ride.
That's okay. We hop on trains. Gives us time to rest.
Wicked dangerous.
Man, that sounds wicked.
You have no idea. It's free and so fucking fun. Well, unless you get caught or fall, but we've been lucky so far. That's the best. Nobody tells us what to do. No corporation owns us.
And you get to see so many cool places.
Exactly. Next stop is Humboldt County, California.
Stoner break.
Not even close. We actually got work over there.
Sean, what are you doing? We hit the tree with Chris. It's all crooked like an old witch. Oh, hi. Who are you? Ooh, your hair looks so cool. Is it a wig?
Well, what do you think?
I don't know, but it's really cool. I'm Daniel. What's your name?
Hi, Daniel. I'm Cassidy. I dig your superhero outfit.
I'm on a secret mission with my friend. It's very dangerous.
I can tell. I hope you get your mission accomplished. And what's your name?
Oh, Sean. I thought I told you.
No, you did.
Sorry, you went through some shit with the guys. How much you make? You ready? Hello, pups.
Pups.
Ooh, is that your doggy? So cool.
Yeah, he's been through a lot. Like most of us. So we adopted him. And he stinks. Yeah, you stink and you like it, huh?
Well, he's not the only one.
Have you checked your hair? I think it just twitched. You should keep your distance, dude.
He looks cool, never too careful. Huh.
She looks really cool, I think.
See? He knows I'm clean. You're the nasty one.
Yeah, you always go for those suburban boys.
Are you kidding? You want to talk about your scoreboard, hotshot?
Hey, no worries.
Come on, let's bail.
It was nice meeting you, Sean and Daniel.
Stay out of trouble,
goodbye.
Kids.
Hope we see you on the rails someday.
Yeah. See you around.
Your doggy was so cute. I miss Mushroom.
I miss her too.
Hey, excuse me. Dogs have to be on a leash around here. Uh-oh. Too many strays.
Sorry, dude. We don't do leashes.
Well, the city does. An unleashed dog is liable to a fine, so...
You're gonna fine our dog? Well, that's not very nice.
Loitering is illegal too. And you don't live here, right? Right?
Calm down, sweetie. We're allowed to visit the Christmas market. Our dog's not gonna eat you. Look at him.
You better watch your mouth. You punks are always causing trouble. This is a nice town, okay?
Jeez. Someone needs to get laid.
He's out of pills.
That's it. I'm calling the cops.
Uh-oh. Oh, God. He's gonna call the cops on us, Finn.
Chill out. We're leaving this shithole anyway. You guys don't even have a Santa, for Christ's sake.
Merry Christmas.
Fucking parasites.
Why did they fight? I don't get why he yelled like that. Should we do something about it?
This kid just wants to fuck shit up. No, I don't want to prank. I do want to prank him, but... That, you see that little burst right there? That's going to have bad consequences.
Better not get involved, man. This guy... doesn't look nice.
You're right.
Yeah, he doesn't look nice at all. Looks like
they're pretty.
Dick. Well, Daniel, I think I got a gift for you last time we checked. So, I don't know when I'm gonna give it to you.
So cool.
But, what's up, Grandma? Let's go right here, I guess. Oh, sorry. Bender. Okay. What's still our goal? Our goal is still the same. Find Charles to leave the market. Alright, Charles. Let's go. Okay. The fuck is that?
Hey. Yeah. You guys ready to go?
Done.
Cool. Hop in.
I think that's a glitch too.
Are you having too much fun back there?
Yeah.
That's what I thought.
Car's driving itself. Bye, Charles.
Looks like Daniel found a new brother.
No kidding. He dumped me like a rock.
I'm glad you two came along. It's great that Chris found a new friend out here. It looks like you did too. What's her name?
Cassidy.
Cassidy? Cassidy.
Cute name. Do you like her?
Just wanted money. She was cool.
She was cool.
You're too quick!
Anyway,
got ya!
It's good for me to get out, too. We've had a rough time over the past couple of years. My wife, Emily, she died 2 years ago. Obviously, it was tough on Chris.
Shit. I'm sorry, man.
Thanks. It's been a struggle, especially trying to be a good dad.
Doing your best, having problems.
Do you have some kind of problems?
Like, I'm just do you beat your kid, motherfucker?
Not the man I was. I shouldn't have even brought this up, you know, just forget it.
No worries. Didn't mean to make you feel bad.
We all have our ups and downs, right? That's how life works. Your grandparents sure did have their share of downs, too. But they're always there for us. For Chris. They seem like good people.
Players hard. They're nice. Mom left.
They're so nice, but yeah, they have their problems too.
Sorry for bringing that up.
It's okay. I hope they don't stress out because we haven't come back.
Yeah, we should get you two home. Don't keep them waiting.
Yeah.
Hey, buddy. Wanna set up that Christmas tree?
Yeah!
Well, I'll get there before you with my dadmobile.
No way you can beat Captain Spirit. See you later, Super Wolf.
Hello? Hello?
Why are they not here yet? It's kind of weird.
Claire? Steven?
Looks like Grandma and Grandpa haven't come back from church yet.
Well, at least they won't yell at us for going out.
That was so cool to spend time with Chris at the market. Did you know Chris's mom was an artist?
I didn't. How so?
She drew comics. You should see her drawings. They're so cool. Just like yours.
Thanks, dude.
Hey.
What? What is it?
Sean? I want to go check on the room. Upstairs. I know it's Mom's. Please.
Oh, no. It will freak out. Fuck it, dude. Let's do something. Let's do something adventurous.
You won't give up on that, right?
Just do it.
It's just...
Fuck it.
I really want to know what's inside. What kind of stuff she had. Chris has tons of things that belong to his mom. And I have nothing. Come on, Sean. You don't even have to come with me. If you don't want to.
Fuck it. I'll come with you.
Fuck it. Let's do it.
So you don't make a mess and get us caught.
Let's just do it, dude. Fuck it. Fuck it. Alright. Let's see. Thing is, how do we open the door?
We'll find a way to open it.
Sean, this is super easy. I can just break the lock with my power.
Yeah. I could do that with a hammer. But let's try and find the key instead. Alright?
Alright, so it's gotta be in their bedroom.
I'm just gonna clean up real quick.
Okay, let's see. Where can they have it?
Yeah, no. No way I'm searching Claire's underwear.
Excuse me. Vanity drawer?
Locked drawer.
Dude, hurry.
Maybe the key to Karen's room is inside.
Nightstand?
Come on, little key. Don't be shy.
A small key.
Definitely not the one.
It's
way too small.
What is this?
Didn't know Claire had sleep troubles. I guess, how much more Irish can you be?
Alright, so I think this little key is for this.
They might come back any minute.
Yes,
Yeah, it's definitely for this.
Whoa. I'm just looking for a key. Not the crown jewels. Ew. Are these...
Oh, those are her teeth.
Milk teeth? Not sure if it's gross or cute.
Wow.
But still, no key here.
Alright, let's look here.
Okay, Steven. Where do you hide this key?
Oh, God.
Yeah. Not much to see in here.
Oh, my God. Those were his fake teeth.
Shit. These are Christmas presents? Let's not tell Daniel.
Dirty laundry.
This whole house is pretty much a huge washing machine.
Search.
Yes.
What? Just found the key.
I found one key, so it better fit.
Just try it.
Just when I was giving up hope.
Wow.
Oh, Lord.
There's not that much left. Where do you think they put the rest of her stuff?
Claire and Steven must have thrown a lot of it away. The rest is probably packed in these boxes.
Sean? What do you think happened to all the stuff in my room?
Huh.
When we left?
I don't know, Enano. I wish I could answer that.
Okay.
Okay, so let's see this letter down at the bed.
Man. That pen pal sure loved listening to her own voice.
So there's a chest here. Let's open this chest up. Roller skates. How about this camera?
Karen liked to take pictures of strangers when we walked down the streets. Never been a big fan of hiking. I think I saw a moon eclipse once.
I don't know.
Before Daniel was born.
I don't think she used any perfume.
Karen was still with us. I miss my skateboard.
Okay.
And going to the park.
So,
with Lila. I don't have
any memories of her, Sean.
I know.
What else can we look for in here? I think we've pretty much kind of just had an idea of what the hell's in here. CD player. We'll play that.
I think it's not plugged.
How weird are these sunglasses?
They're not so. This playlist is boring as hell. They're not sunglasses, man. It's to look at the sun during.
Let's plug the CD player. I don't know if that's gonna trigger anything.
Woo! Did she tell you why she left?
I'm so sick!
She told Dad, and Dad told me. He told you too, right?
All he ever said to me was she wasn't so sure what she wanted with her life.
Well, I guess she finally figured it out. Because she never looked back. And we have to do.
Hi, teddy bear.
The fuck is wrong with this? Oh, hiding spot. Smart. So, Karen was already serious about running away.
Hop on whenever, jump
off
forever.
Why did you wait that long?
From Portland, New York. Wow, okay. Well, now we know where she went. I'm sorry I keep picking my nose, like brushing off my nose. I'm super sick, guys. I don't think there's anything else to look at here. Old phone.
So, you were a friend of my mommy's?
Guess the no phone rule wasn't such a thing back then.
Good care of you.
Okay. All right, buddy. This one letter here. Open the letter. Let's see.
Why would Claire lock these up in here?
Is that for Mom? Huh? Let me see.
Daniel! Come on.
What's it say? Read it.
Seriously, stop. Here, how about this?
I've heard the news about Seattle. Please help my boys if they come to you.
What?
What? Why did they hide this from us?
I don't know.
You can reach me at this address. It's a P.O. box I use sometimes.
What?
What's a P.O. box?
Well, a cop-out in this case.
I beg you, please help my sons.
Oh, yeah, right. Total bullshit.
What do you mean? She cares about us.
Well, I don't.
Maybe she changed her mind. We could try and contact her.
You don't even know her, okay? Don't get any wrong ideas. We should just stick to our plan. For now.
Can I read it again?
Yeah. Then we gotta go.
My goodness.
Oh, shit.
Excuse me. What are you both doing in here? Except visibly. Ransacking our house while we're at church? Well, is that all you have to say?
Claire, please, calm down.
No, Stephen. They went way out of line here. We specifically told you to stay out of this room.
I just wanted to see my mom stop.
This isn't her room anymore. There is nothing to see in here. It's time you learn to respect some rules.
Actually, we did find something.
Yeah, we found a new letter from my mom. She said she wants to see us. But you didn't even tell us.
She's not my daughter anymore, or your mother. She burned all those bridges. One letter doesn't change what she did to me. All of us. She is not welcome back.
It's been 8 years. Maybe it's time to move on.
Don't you dare lecture me, Sean. You don't know anything about how I feel.
I can't hear that.
Listen, Sean. I know life has been tough on you the past month. Bless your souls. And we put up with a lot of things. But that, going through our stuff, our personal belongings.
Oh, man, we're gonna get kicked out.
That shows you don't respect us. We could go to jail just for helping you. This is how you pay us back? Well, things are just going to change around here if you want to stay.
Man, I think I see why Mom left now. She couldn't put up with your stupid rules anymore.
Oh, so that's what you think. Then let me tell you something. Steven!
Oh, shit! Get this goddamn thing off me!
Steven, no! Hold on, honey, we'll get it off!
He's gonna use his powers.
No! Stop! Oh, my legs!
Live together, use power. Fuck it, dude. I don't care. I'm gonna do something risky.
Do it, Daniel! Now!
Do what? What's going on? Oh, Lord, what? What are you doing, Daniel?
Like a boss.
Oh, my baby, Stephen, are you okay?
Now I am. Thanks to Daniel. You were right, Claire. I should have fixed that cupboard months ago. I guess my laziness will get me someday.
What in the name of God was that all about? That's impossible. What are you, Daniel?
Claire.
What are you?
Listen.
They saved me, Claire. That's all that matters.
Maybe. It was a miracle. Oh, thank you, Lord.
Oh, shit.
It's the sheriff.
Stephen? Claire?
Sean, I didn't. We didn't call them.
I know, Grandma.
Someone called us. We know they've been here. Apparently, someone logged onto your grandson's Facebook page.
Sean, what are we gonna do?
Go hide in the garage.
No. No. No way. If the police searches the house, that makes the two of you accomplices.
Get your bags and go out the back door. I'll distract him.
Really?
Yes. No. Get the hell out of here.
I know you're in here. Your car's in the driveway.
I'm so sorry for everything. I wish we could have helped you more.
Aww.
I wish you could stay here with us. Watch out for your brother, Sean.
Yes. Be careful. We'll see you as soon as we can, okay?
Thanks for helping us. Both of you.
Oh, we love you. Now hurry up.
Daniel, wait for me while I go upstairs.
Fuck, dude.
Thank you.
it from the cops. Are we gonna hide at the neighbor's house?
Wait, cover fell on me?
What?
Why did Chris jump in front of that car, Sean?
Because he thought he had superpowers. Because of you.
He's okay, Enano. The car barely touched him.
You said I should be more careful. But because of you, I didn't do anything, and I could have.
Hey, you don't know what could have happened, okay? What's done is done.
Hey, you could have flipped that car over.
Didn't you let me check on him? What if he is dead?
You could see the car slow down before, so Chris will be fine. Trust me.
You promise?
Oh, God, I don't want to lie to him.
Promise.
I think he's dead. Do you imagine if he's dead?
Sean.
His dad will go nuts.
I'm tired of running away. I don't want to be a superhero anymore.
You don't have to use your power if you don't want to.
I know, but sometimes I can help, and how do I know when to use it?
You don't. You can only trust your guts and listen to your brother.
You think we'll see Grandma and Grandpa again?
I don't know. We'll see.
Where are we gonna go now? See?
Damn, dude.
See Mom?
No way, man. We don't need her, okay?
But she said she wanted to find us.
We stick to the plan. We go to Puerto Lobos. That's where we belong. No one will tell us what to do. We can be whoever we want.
You think? I don't know.
Trust me, man. From now on, we make our own rules. Look, I wanted to wait until then, but we kind of need a little cheer, so. Merry Christmas, Enano.
For me? Thanks, Sean. Hey, listen.
There's a ride. Come on, all aboard.
Oh, God. Taking the train. Are we gonna meet these people? So I think that their mom is not bad. Their mom ran away for a reason that obviously the game doesn't want to tell us yet. But it's kind of like when you play Life is Strange Before the Storm. The mom wasn't as bad as we thought. Or when she discovered the truth about her mom or whatever it was. It was like a twist. I don't remember right now. But it was like a crazy twist towards the end. And I feel like this is heading the same direction. Anyways, there you have it, guys. Life is Strange, Episode 2. Rules. That was kind of crazy. The ending, the gameplay overall was a little slow, but that's how Life is Strange is. It's more of a, like, for viewing pleasure more than anything. I think I would have changed some of the choices I made. I was just kind of paranoid that shit was gonna go sideways for us. We managed to escape, though. I don't know if there is an ending that you get caught by the cops or something, but I still feel like if Daniel would have used his powers with that cop car there, I think it could have possibly been worse. I don't know, maybe not, but that's just my opinion. Anyways, there you have it. That's going to conclude today's episode of Life is Strange 2. That is episode 2. And as always, thank you guys for watching. If you enjoyed it, leave it a like.